That's what we want to be. We want to be the teachers that don't have the battles, not that win the battles. We don't want to have the battles. How do you do that? Well, and why? It says rapport provides you with the information you need to create powerful hooks. So how can you know what is going to engage your audience if you haven't done the work on the front end to figure out what they're into? So you have to always be trying to learn as much as you can about your students so that that can help you design the hooks that will draw them into your content. Now, some of these things I'm doing today are just things that are human nature kind of hooks. But other hooks you can use, do you know what kind of music they listen to? Do you know what TV shows are big right now? What's the big movie right now? What's going on campus? What's going on in the city around you with sports or whatever it might be? These are all natural things that you can draw in because they're already into them, so you can take advantage of that. Rapport allows you to create buy-in. I know there's things that I get my students to do in class that other teachers would not be able to get away with because the students would just say, I'm not doing that. Well, on the first day of school, my students wouldn't do that either, probably. But I go through enormous lengths to create an environment that's safe to be a little bit silly, to let your hair down a little bit, to have fun and be outrageous. So creating that environment where there's a sense of safety is of utmost importance. And I noticed that as part of the Great Expectations methodology too. That's super, super important.